shaped by Clearest Blue.
We were trying to make a laid back song, weren't we?
That's the thing about this band, though. We always like set out with rules, and then we're useless at sticking to them. Like, the other rule for this song was, let's do a song with two chords. And of course, 10 minutes later, Martin's off on another, you know, with the minor. But that's, you know, that's the fun part, is like creating boundaries and then smashing them, you know?
And then you start to try and do it, and it doesn't quite work out where you planned. But then you've got a different idea, and then that's where you take the song.
It's a useful jumping off point, like,
mm. Yeah.
So the rules were to make a laid back song with only two chords.
Yeah. It went well.
After the kind of basic track is down, like the chords or a beat or like a sample loop or whatever, is that we'll kind of like bounce ideas around between each other. Martin kind of pulls it together a bit and like puts down a track of his own vocals, just kind of singing nonsense, kind of silly words so that don't mean anything. And that kind of defines the kind of vocal phrasing and, you know, the basic shapes that end up in the final track.
That stuff is the first thing that comes into my head.
Take that demo and I go across the hall to write lyrics while those guys work on the music. Either I'll look through a notebook to try and find words that I've written, or sometimes there'll be a certain word that it sounds like Martin said, and then that's what I'll write off of. There's a bit where it sounds like he's saying, like I always do. And then I was like, oh. And then I was like, that bit should repeat. Those two lines should come in couples every time in the verse. And that's kind of how that bit started. Like I always was, like I always was, and then it's not enough, not enough. Like I always was, like I always was, but it's not enough, it's not enough, not enough. Whenever I feel it coming on, you can be well aware. If ever I try to push away, you can just keep me there. So please say you made me. Meet me halfway. I think at the time I thought I was writing a love song. When I was writing it, it was kind of coming from the standpoint of wanting to believe in something and wanting to believe that it can be so, but not being sure if the surrounding circumstances will allow that to happen. To me, the phrase, we are tied to the shifting ground, is like circumstances constantly changing. Tied to the shifting ground. Like I always was. I was trying to be hopeful. Shaped by Clearest Blue.